Welcome back. When you're vlogging outdoors in bright sunlight, lighting can be a challenge. You're probably outside because there's a nice background and you want to show it. But if you're exposing for your face in the shade, the background's going to be white. It's going to be overexposed, which isn't good. So if you expose for the background, this happens. Your face gets dark. Now the background's correctly exposed. So what you need in order to show the background properly is to have light on your face. Look at the difference when you have lights. Wow. So that's what this video is about, is what can you do when you're on location, traveling out there in the world, and you want to have nice lighting on your face while you're outside vlogging. You need lights that are portable, you need lights that are battery powered, and that are not a hassle to take with you. So I have assembled an army of lights that I think fits that description. They're small, they're portable, they're lightweight, and they're battery powered. No electrical cords needed. You can take them on location. You can put them in a suitcase. We're leaving on vacation tomorrow for Kauai, and I'm going to be doing a lot of vlogs in beautiful locations. And I want to make sure I have video lights that make my face look kind of good, but I need to be able to carry them to the location and not be hassled by it. So this is actually a functional test for me too. I want to find out what will work. Now obviously you're not going to get as bright as the sun, and if you could, you might as well just be in the sun. But I want to find out, will these light up the face enough to make it worthwhile to look good? I'm going to have one light on each side about 30 inches from my face to get the flat lighting. That's why I have a light on each side of my face. So I'm curious to see which is the brightest. These are all battery powered and lightweight. These are all different companies. I'm curious. Let's find out how these hold up outside. Okay, so I have a nice background behind me, and this is what it looks like with no light on my face. This is just the shadow side. So let's try to start putting some light on my face. All right, starting off, we have two Stellas. These are 7K Stellas. They cost about $1,200 each. They have a battery built in to the light, so you don't have a cord, you don't have a box attached to it or anything. The Stella comes with an optional Fresnel lens, which really helps intensify the amount of light. It focuses it more, and in effect, almost like helps double the amount of light. It's held on kind of flimsily by the barn doors, and what's kind of cool about it is it's not glass. This is actually kind of a rubbery material, which is actually silicone. It's flexible, so it can't break like glass, and it's a lot lighter. They really put a lot of thought into helping keep the weight down and making it small. So this is that's another thing that I really like about this. Fresnels are an amazing, amazing invention. They really help intensify the amount of light coming out of a light, and I wish all lights would have something like this, so you don't even have to use as much power and get the same amount of light. The only thing I don't like about this setup is the way it attaches to the light. It's held in place by the barn doors, which is a really actually pops into the barn doors, and then you attach it on like that, which seems kind of easy, but look how easy it comes off. It doesn't take much to make it come off. I really hope they fix this problem. But Fresnels are an amazing thing to have on your lights. I love the size of the Stellas, so I have 8 of them. They're just so practical to have. They have some fan noise when they're at full power, like 7,000 or 8,000. When they're down to 5,000, the fan noise is so low you can't even hear it. For sheer portability and power, nothing comes close to the Stella. I mean, look at it. This is the light. This is so easy to just take with you when you're traveling. A couple of these, even 4 of these, I've got 6 of them. I mean, it collapses down. This is it's got the power supply and the light built in to one unit. No cords, no bulky battery. This, for sheer power, I mean, these things put out a lot of power. For sheer power and portability, nothing comes close to the Stella. The only thing going against these is they're very expensive and they have some fan noise. When you're outside like this, you probably can't hear it. When you're indoors, you will. All right, now I have 2 bit lighter flashlights. They're very portable. They're basically flashlights that are made for photography, and they're at, everything that I do is at full power, so this is at full power. They're not that bright, but they're I mean, if you're in the dark, it would work, but against sunlight, they don't really hold up that well. I put a third bit lighter up just to see if it made a difference. So it's a little bit brighter. Whoa, this is bright. This is six of the world's brightest LED flashlights bunched together. I got three on each side, and it's pretty darn bright. The problem is they're on the blue side, so the color's kind of not that white balanced, and they're really focused on a small spot, so I have to back them up. So I set them back. That one's about 4 feet back. That one's about 5 feet back. And it's just blue light, and it's just. All right, now I have two pairs of Bolt 250s by Core. These are bi-color lights that you can adjust for daylight or tungsten. I like to have them a little half of each, so it's half daylight, half tungsten. It gives the face a little bit of a warmer glow. They're 250 watt equivalent of a normal light, so that's quite a punch for a little cube. And they use normal little batteries. They're pretty bright. I take these on vacation a lot. I have for many years, but I'm seeing if any of these other ones are even brighter. Again, so this is four Bolt 250s by Core. All right, that was it for the portable. Now we're getting into the actual LED panels. These are the smallest of the panels. They're really cute. They're very portable. They have 576 LEDs, and they still use the same little portable batteries that the Bolt uses, and they're really cute. And they're so cheap, you can get a bunch of them like this. All right, so now I have four of these little lights around me. Now before you go, four lights, that's ridiculous. That's not portable anymore, that's overkill. Actually, no, these lights, when they put them all together, this is how much space it takes up. It's really not that much. They're very flat, very small, very lightweight. They're easy to carry, even when you have four of them. And the reason I like to have multiple lights is because the more light you have wrapping around your face, the softer the light is on your face. Now some people just like to put one light on top of their camera, and that's fine if you're 20 years old, but I'm almost 60. And the more softer light that I can get, the better. So this is just what I prefer. You don't have to do it, but I prefer it. Now these lights are not the brightest lights there are, but a lot of little lights equals the output of one big light. So I'd rather, instead of having one light right here aiming at me, to have the light distributed more around me, which makes softer light. So that's just me. I like to distribute the light output around me more, so there's less shadows and more soft light. So I like these little lights. They're very small, very lightweight, very portable, and they don't cost much. All right, moving up a notch, here these lights have three times as many bulbs as the last one. Each one of these has almost 1,200 little LEDs. These ones, though, need V-mount batteries, which are heavy and awkward and bulky to use, but they're powerful batteries. They're much taller lights, so you get more coverage on each side of your face. They're from China, they're generic, they're not that expensive. I think they're a couple hundred bucks. I'll put the links to everything down below. Here's the newer version of these. These ones just came out. These require two V-mount batteries each. They last longer, they're more powerful, but two V-mount batteries is a lot of weight, and I don't think you want to carry that with you when you're traveling in your luggage. But they are longer, and they really put out a good amount of light, and because they're really long, they really help soften out your face. I have probably 30 of these. I just like these. I get a bunch of these from China, or there's a place in the United States that sells them. I'll give you the link down below. All right, now I'm using the famous Lupo Super Panel from Italy. These things are great. I love them. They're expensive. They're $1,200 or something like that. They're 1 foot by 1 foot panels. They require a V-mount battery, but I really like them. They really put out a great amount of light, and good quality light too. These are professional lights, and I like them. They are portable. I have taken them in my suitcase because they're so flat. They don't take up a lot of space in your suitcase. They're not really that bulky, and they are quite bright, and they are very usable in the real world. So I really like the Lupo Super Panels. I highly recommend them. They are expensive. Again, this is what it looks like without lighting, in case you've forgotten. All right, these are Godox SLB60s. There's two of them. I like these. I just like everything by Godox. They use 60 watts of power. It's not an equivalent of a 60 watt light bulb. It means they use 60 watts of power, which for LEDs is a lot more. They have a Bowens mount, so you can put Bowens mount anything on them, softboxes, whatever. The only thing I don't like about these Godoxes is the fan noise. You can hear the fans. Why did they do this? That means you can't use it when you're doing audio recordings. I mean, I know I'm doing it right now, and I can hear it. You probably can't because of all the traffic and the airplanes and helicopters and everything. But if I was in a quiet room or if I was in a quiet environment, you could definitely hear the fans. But I love everything else about them. I wish they would, well, I'm sure they're going to get rid of it. I mean, things get upgraded, so I'm just going to hope for the best. Anyway, I love these things. I love everything about them except for the fan noise. Did I say that already? All right, these are Aputure 120D Mark IIs, the second generation. On this side, I have the standard parabolic reflector, and on this side, blinding me, is the Fresnel attachment, which is a lens that focuses the light a lot more and intensifies and almost doubles the light output. So as you can see, the Fresnel really amps up the power. I mean, this is super bright. I'm amazed how bright that is. And it's not extra electricity being used, it's just a lens that's focusing the light more, and you can adjust it for small spot or wide. Right now it's set on small spot, so it's intense. Wow, it's intense. All right, I have Fresnels on both of these right now. It is so bright I can't even open my eyes, but I wanted to demonstrate. If I expose from my face, look at the background. That's bright sunny day back there. That is fully huge, massive amount of light back there, and I can turn it down to look like nighttime if I expose my face with these lights. That's how bright these things are. They are so bright. Matter of fact, there's heat coming up. I feel like there's blow torches on my face. It's that hot. And these are LEDs. These are LEDs. Look how bright they can get. This is amazing. These are Aputure 120D Mark IIs with Fresnels on them. And the Fresnels are set to 20 degrees, which is not even focused all the way. This is only halfway. If I focus all the way, the light output is even more intense. It's just a tinier dot, which means you're gonna only get like a little tiny spot of light. But the light intensity is so, wow. It's like the heat of the sun on my face. All right, now I have the Fresnel set all the way wide. This is as wide as they go, so the power output is less. But still, look how dark the background is. That is full bright sunny day, where usually the sky is white. It's washed out. I can make it like so dark back there with these, just having Fresnels on them. This is just amazing. The only thing is, I mean, it's so bright, I can't open my eyes barely. I can't even see the LED screen. I can't even see what I'm doing. I'm hoping I'm on the camera. I think we've hit the max with this setup here. This is like, you don't need more light than this. All right, back to the real world scenario. I have the power turned down to 75%. The Fresnels are all the way wide, and I made the background more realistically exposed as compared to the other shots we did. So this is, I can start to open my eyes again a little bit, and this is more of a realistic usable scenario. I still got the Fresnels on. I just wanted to show you the different steps, the different levels. The cool thing is when you're using Fresnels, it intensifies the light so much that you can turn the power down and you can save power and electricity. The batteries last a lot longer. So even though you have almost the same output as when you're just using a standard parabolic reflector, you're using half the power with Fresnels. So when you're on location, how long your batteries last is kind of important. So this is, I mean, I'm just amazed at this. This is the exact same settings, but I switched the Fresnels for the standard parabolic reflectors. Look at the difference. The power is at 75% for both lights. Nothing's changed except I took the Fresnels off and put the standard parabolic reflectors on. My face is too dark. That's how much power difference there is just putting the Fresnel on. So I'm going to turn up the power. Turn the power back up to 100% on both lights. Now we have it usable again. Look at the difference that the Fresnels make. I love these lights. The only thing I don't like about them is they're bigger, they're bulkier, they have the cable coming off going to a power unit that has a big giant V-mount battery on it. It's not like a single little self-contained thing. It's like all this stuff you got to carry around. So for portability, it's not the greatest, but they can be portable. That's what they're designed for. And they do put out great amount of light. So every light has its pluses and minuses. A 120 with a Fresnel and a small V-mount battery weighs 13 pounds, that's a lot. Whereas a Stella weighs under 3 pounds. So you could have 4 Stellas for the same size and weight as one 120. These use the heavy V-mount batteries, which I don't like V-mount batteries because they're just so heavy. I like little lightweight things. But look at the power output. This is a professional gear. The 120Ds are the same size as the Godox SLB60Ws, but they put out more light, obviously. These ones are heavier, just something to keep in mind. But they definitely put out power. The 300s are coming out in a couple months. I'm gonna try those too. They're like more than double the output of these ones. These are really nice lights. I really like the quality of Aputure, especially the 120Ds. These are nice, really nice. Okay, so which is the brightest? Well, the 120D Mark II with the Fresnel is, of course, the brightest, but without the Fresnel, just the standard parabolic, it's about as bright as a Stella, which would make the Lupo Super Panel the brightest professional light. Now, I say professional because the Glare Beam flashlight is the second brightest one of all, but it has blue light, the spot's too small, it's just not usable in realistic scenarios, so I would take this out of the running. All right, so the brightest is the 120D Mark II with Fresnel, then the Lupo Super Panel, then the BL2280P panel, but that's more of a studio light. It's not really portable. Then the Stella, then the JW1500Ds from China. It's a good all-purpose light. Then the Godox SLB60W, good quality light, nice package, but it has fan noise. Then the cute little BL2220P. It's not very bright, but for the price, you can get a number of them. And then the Core Bolt Torch LED 250. It's so practical, small, and portable. You could do what I do and take like four of them. And then there's the BitLighter Pro. It's not bright enough for daylight use, but it makes a great nighttime video light. I have all of this plus what they weigh and the prices on a JPEG you can download in the link below. So what's my conclusion after all this? Which ones do I pick? Which ones I'm gonna take on my trips? Well, bar none, the Stellas are the smallest, most portable. If I have to go and just grab something in a pinch that I know is powerful and small, Stellas are the way to go because they are just so small and self-contained and they're powerful and they're just so easy to set up. So Stellas is number one. Number two, of course, the 120Ds, the apertures are like the ultimate light to take with you if you have the room and the weight ability. They're just bigger and bulkier and more awkward to take around with you, but as far as sheer power and flexibility and ability to get any kind of professional shot you want, those are the ones to get if you're really professional and you really want to get, like, you know, have, you're covered in all areas. The third choice would be the Lupo Super Panels. They're flat. They're 1 foot by 1 foot, but they're really flat and they don't take up that much space in a suitcase. You put them between your clothes, and they're really bright. But they're nowhere near as small as the Stellas. You could, four Stellas could take the space of one Lupo. So anyway, those are my three choices. After all that I've done would be the Stella 8000, the Lupo Super Panel, and the Aperture 120D Mark II with the Fresnels. Two lights each for me, because I like the soft beauty lighting. You don't need that probably because you're younger than me, you don't need it. So for this trip, the Stellas are going for sure. I'm still kind of iffy about taking a Lupo or the 120s. They have their own purposes and reasons, so I might fill one suitcase with nothing but lights. That's just who I am. I don't know, everybody, whatever. It's just, I make it up as I go. So there you have it. I tested each of these lights in the dark with a light meter to see exactly the differences in light. So I'm gonna post that below so you can see the actual numbers, what the lights are, how to get them, what they cost, the size, and all of that. So I hope this helps. This is for me too, because I wanna know what's the brightest thing I can take with me that's not gonna be a problem to take, that's small, lightweight, portable, battery powered. And I'm constantly looking for newer things. So if you know anything, let me know. If I know something, I share it with you. That's what the community is about. This is photography. It's all fun. It's all to make the world a more beautiful place and to capture that beauty and to share it with others. That's really what photography, I think, should be, is to capture the beauty of the world. It's very fleeting, so others can see it in the moment that it happens. I'll see you in the next video. And in the next video, I'm going to show you how to do flattering lighting outside with no lights. See you in the next video.